we're back live.
Don't forget to like and subscribe to the Social Majora YouTube channel and check out our website, socialmajora.ca. Sorry about that inconvenience. We don't know where we cut out. So we're just going to reread the entire chapter of Genesis 36, if we even got any of the live.
Yeah, I'm not sure where the phone died. I'm having battery problems. We're plugged in now. We're going to try this again. Welcome back again. We're redoing Genesis chapter 36. This is the account of the family line of Esau, that is Edom. Esau took his wives from the women of Canaan. Adah, daughter of Elon, the Hittite, and Oholibamah, daughter of Anah, the grandfather of Zibeon, the Hivite. Also Basemath, daughter of Ishmael, sister of Nebaiah. Okay. Just want to stop there because Ishmael is probably way more important than we let on, because we know who Ishmael is, right?
You do?
Yeah. Ishmael was Abraham's other son. Right?
Yeah, totally.
Isaac's half brother, Esau's uncle. So, anyways. Adah bore Eliphaz to Esau. Basemath bore Reuel. Oholibamah bore Jehuz, Jalam, and Koran. These are the sons of Esau, who were born to him in Canaan. Esau took his wives and sons and daughters and all the members of his household, as well as all his livestock and all the other animals and all the goods he had acquired in Canaan, and moved to a land some distance from his brother Jacob. Their possessions were too great for them to remain together. The land where they were staying could not support them both because of their livestock. So Esau, that is Edom, settled in the hill country of Seir. This is the account of the family line of Esau, the father of the Edomites, in the hill country of Seir. These are the names of Esau's sons: Eliphaz, son of Esau's wife Adah; Reuel, son of Esau's wife Basemath. The sons of Eliphaz: Teman, Omar, Zepho, Gadam, and Kenaz. Esau's sons Eliphaz also had a concubine named Timnah, who bore him Amalek. These are the grandsons of Esau's wife Adah. The sons of Reuel: Nathan, Sarah, Shammah, Mizah. These are the grandsons of Esau's wife Basemath. The sons of Esau's wife Oholibamah, daughter of Anah, the granddaughter of Zibeon, whom she bore to Esau: Jehuz, Jalam, and Korah. These were the chiefs among Esau's descendants. The sons of Eliphaz, the firstborn of Esau's chiefs: Teman, Omar, Zepho, Kenaz, Korah, Gadam, Amalek. These were the chief descendants of Eliphaz and Edom. They were the grandsons of Adah. The sons of Esau's sons: Reuel, chiefs: Nahath, Zerah, Shammah, and Mizah. These were the chief descendants of Reuel and Edom. They were the grandsons of Esau's wife Basemath. The sons of Esau's wife Oholibamah: chief Jehuz, Jalam, and Korah. These were the chief descendants of Esau's wife Oholibamah, daughter of Anah. These were the sons of Esau, that is Edom. And these were the chiefs. These were their chiefs. Here are some of the sons. These were the sons of Seir the Horite, who were living in the region: Lotan, Shabul, Zibeon, Anah, Dishon, Ezer, and Dishan. These were the sons of Seir, and Edom were Horite chiefs. The sons of Lotan: Hori and Homan, Timnah, and Lotan's sister. The sons of Shubal: Elvan, Manahath, Ebal, Shepho, and Onam. The sons of Zibeon: Ai and Anah. This is the Anah who discovered the hot springs in the desert while he was grazing the donkeys of his father Zibeon. The children of Anah: Dishon, Oholibamah, daughter of Anah. The sons of Dishon: Hemdan, Eshban, Ithran, Karan. The sons of Ezer: Bilhan, Zaban, and Akan. the sons of Dishon, Uz, and Aran. These were the Horite chiefs, Lotan, Shobal, Zibeon, Anah, Dishon, Ezer, and Dishon. These were the Horite chiefs according to their divisions in the land of Seir. These were the kings who reigned in Edom before the Israelite kings reigned. Bela, son of Beor, became king of Edom. His city was named Dinhabah. When Bela died, Jabab, son of Zahar, come from Bozrah, succeeded him as king. When Jabab died, Hushin, from the land of the Timnites, succeeded him as king. When Hushin died, Hadad, son of Bedad, who defeated the Midian in the country of Moab, succeeded him as king. His city was named Avith. When Hadad died, Samla, son of Masrekah, succeeded him as king. When Samla died, Shaul, son of Rehoboth, in the river, succeeded him as king. When Shaul died, Baal-Hanan, son of Akbar, succeeded him as king. When Baal-Hanan, son of Akbar, died, Hadad succeeded him as king. His city was named Pau. His wife's name was Mehetabel, daughter of Matred, the daughter of Mezabab. These were the chief descendants from Esau by name, according to their clans and regions. Timnah, Elva, Jahath, Oholibama, Elha, Pinan, Kanez, Temnon, Ibzar, Magdal, and Iram. These were the chiefs of Edom according to their settlement in the land that they occupied. This is the family line of Esau, the father of the Edomites. Alright, so that's the second time I've read through all those names.
Okay, well then I can get Michael asking.
Probably did it better the first time, but I'm sorry.
I should probably ask my question for a second time.
What?
Who named somebody Basemath?
I thought we were already... We
discussed this when the live was cut out.
Yeah. Ada. That's who does it.
Why?
I don't know. They just named people differently back then. They're probably sitting there going, who named somebody Rowan? So, you know, actually that is kind of a weird name. Who named somebody Doug? That's a normal name. Somebody named Larry. So, you know, we had different names. That's all. Different culture, different language, different names.
Okay.
Also, Basemath is a girl's name. So, there's that. So, yeah. Any other questions? Any other questions?
No.
No? Any prayer requests?
No.
All right, let's pray. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for all that you give us. We thank you for your word. We pray that we learn from it. Maybe we'll come up with some cool names to name our kids someday. We love you and praise you, Lord Jesus. This we pray in Lord Jesus Christ's name. Amen. All right, we'll see you tomorrow evening at 8:30 for another moment of joy. Bye-bye.